ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಅಥವಾ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠವಾದ ವಾಕ್ಯಗಳು. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ನೋ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೀ ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾಕ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಕಲಿಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾಲ್ಕೇ ವಿಷಯ ಕಲಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟೇ, ನಾವು ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ಕಲಿತಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್, ಆಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ಲೆಸ್. ಯಾವುದು ಯೂಸ್ಲೆಸ್ಸು? ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಪಾಡಿಗೆ ಬೇಕೋ? ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಪಾಡಿಗೆ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಕೋ, ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಬೇಕೋ, ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಬೇಕೋ, ಗಂಡಸ್ ಬೇಕೋ? ಫಾರ್ ಸರ್ವೈವಲ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫೋರ್ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ಫೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪೀಸ್. ಶಾಂತಿಗೆ ನಾಲ್ಕೇ ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾಕ್ಯಗಳು, ನಾಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್, ನಾಟ್ ಒನ್ ಲೆಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಅಂದರೆ ಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠವಾದ ಮಾತುಗಳು. ಕೇಳಿದರೆ ಈ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯಗಳನ್ನ ಯಾರು ಹೇಳಪ್ಪ, ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯಗಳನ್ನ? ನೀವಲ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀರಾ? ಉಳಿದವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್? ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಕ್ಸೆಸರಿ. ಏನೇನು ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ? ಆತ್ಮಸಾಕ್ಷಿ, ಅದು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯದ ದಿರವಾದ್ದು. ನೋಡಿಯಪ್ಪ, ನಾವು ಸನಾತನ ಧರ್ಮದವರು ಹೌದಾ? ಭಗವಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮಾತು ಕೇಳಬೇಕು. ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ? ಪೂಜೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರ? ಭಗವಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮಾತು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ? ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಭಗವಂತ ನೀವು ಉದ್ಧಾರ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಕೇಳಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಇದು, ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಶಾಂತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಶಾಂತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ವೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಪೀಸ್? ಪೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಮನುಷ್ಯರು ಹೇಳಿದಲ್ಲ ಇದು. ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಪೌರುಷೇಯ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಒರಿಜಿನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಪೌರುಷೇಯ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಅಪೌರುಷೇಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಎನ್ಸೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸನಾತನ ಧರ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಚುಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಹೋಲ್, ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಹೌ ಬ್ರಿಲಿಯಂಟ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್. ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಬುದ್ಧಿಯನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಇಡೀ ವಿಶ್ವದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಿಶ್ವ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಂತಲ್ಲ, ಆ ವಿಶ್ವದ ಹೇಗೆ ಬಂತು, ಏನ್ ಬಂತು ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಮ್ಯಾನರ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ದೆನ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಸೈಡ್, ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಮ್ಮೆಮೋರಿಯಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಡನ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಪೌರುಷೇಯ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಒರಿಜಿನ್. ನಾನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಒರಿಜಿನ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ಬುದ್ಧಿಗಿಂತ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗಿಂತ ಮೀರಿದ ವಾಕ್ಯಗಳು ಬಂದವು ಅಂತ. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಶ್ರೀಮನ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ವೇ ಇನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಸನಾತನ ಧರ್ಮದಲ್ಲಿ ದೋಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್, ದೋಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್, ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದಿ ಅಥೆಂಟಿಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಆಕ್ಸಿಯಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗ್ರಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಇವನ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್. ವಿ ಮೇ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೇ, ಅವರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಮೇ ಚೇಂಜ್, ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್, ವೆದರ್ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದ ಅಥೆಂಟಿಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್. ಆ ಭಗವಾನ್ ನಾರಾಯಣನಿಂದ ಬಂದದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯದ ಅದು ನಿಜಾನೋ ಸುಳ್ಳು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಕೋಗುದಿಲ್ಲ. ರೈಟ್,
ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಇಟ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅನದರ್ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ, ರೈಟ್?
ನಾಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ.
Okay, still.
There's no entity.
Yeah, but still saying it's some intellectual saying, right?
It's not some intellectual saying. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
In
okay.
other words, it has come as part of creation.
And
the world came, the universe came.
It came.
These are also sounds.
It's called Shabda. But Shabda, in Shabda, there are many things in Shabda. Okay. So this is actually, these are all essential part of Apaurusheya or non-human origin. When I say non-human origin, it comes from pure consciousness. Okay, it is expressed through human body, but it's not from a human mind.
But everything is like that, Guruji. If I am the consciousness,
mm-hmm.
then everything is expressed, right?
No. Here, the difference is there. You are the consciousness, and you can express everything from consciousness, by the consciousness. But your expression cannot indicate something about the totality or what is beyond consciousness, beyond your mind. Right? There are some words which you can speak. It's in the domain of our experience, the domain of our understanding. It's called Anubhava and Anumana.
There is one more thing. And, all along we have said there is no difference between Atma and Brahman. I am Puna. So now we are telling we are part, we can't express the whole.
No.
Is
I'm not
there
speaking of that part.
So
I'm speaking of the guy called Mr. Jagrat. Now he is speaking from Mr. Jagrat's point of view. So Mr. Jagrat is saying, whatever I am talking is coming from consciousness. Now Mr. Jagrat has become a little bit more Jagrat. He says, consciousness is only speaking through me. I am saying perfectly all right. But consciousness is only speaking. But whatever you are speaking, Mr. Jagrat has certain ability. It comes from pratyaksha anumana and observation and inference. Still you are not able to that Mr. Jagrat has no ability to infer about the totality.
Mm-hmm.
Even though he is a scientist.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever observation you make about totality is still incomplete.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So that what they say, it has to be revealed.
Mm-hmm.
Not there's a two difference between reveal and realization.
But these have come in some of the scriptures like Rig Veda, Mahavakyas, four Mahavakyas, what we talk about. It has appeared in different...
Correct.
The Vedas themselves
but
are revelations.
The Vedas themselves are Apaurusheya.
Vedas themselves are...
They are non-human origin.
Yes.
And we cannot... There's interpretations...
So it is not confined to only Rig Veda. Whatever is given in the Rig Veda is all...
Yes. The complete Vedas, Upanishad,
including this,
is Apaurusheya. But what happens is that in Veda, whatever is there, some part of that, most of the part are related to rituals and all, this is about jnana, essence about jnana.
We are taking the
essence of the Vedas,
essence.
Each Veda. Nalku Vedagalu idave, Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvana Veda anta. Ee Vedagalu manushana buddhige miriddu. Okay? Aa Vedagalalli manushinda bandalla adu Bhagavantaninda bandantu nanu tilkolutte. Bhagavantan Narayanande. Namagella Veda odigagutta. Aa Vedalli naalku line odigagutta. ಅದು ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಅನಂತ ವೇದಗಳು ಆದರೆ ವೇದಗಳ ಸಾರವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಇಡೀ ವೇದದ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಸಾರ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಋಗ್ವೇದ ಒಂದು ಸಾರ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಇದೆ ರಜುರ್ವೇದ ಒಂದು ಸಾರ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಸಾಮವೇದ ಒಂದು ಸಾರ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಅಥರ್ವಣ ವೇದದ ಸಾರ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾಕ್ಯಗಳು ನಾಲ್ಕು ವೇದಗಳ ಸಾರ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇವೆ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವೇದಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಋಗ್ವೇದ ಯಜುರ್ವೇದ ಸಾಮವೇದ ಅಥರ್ವಣ ಫೋರ್ ವೇದಾಸ್ ನಾವು ದೇ ಕಂಟೇನ್ ಲಾಡ್ ಆಫ್ technology, science, mathematics, many things. Many of them we can't decode also. Okay? A part of what is decoded has become algebra. A part of decoded has become astronomy. Okay? Even before human mind can see the astronomical scientific discoveries happened, there are many discoveries in Veda which are beyond, predates human being.
Veda itself means knowledge, right?
Yes.
Knowledge is anyways existent. It is through us that knowledge is revealed, right?
That's what I'm saying. Revealed knowledge and there is the inferred knowledge.
Huh.
That's the difference between revealed knowledge and inferred knowledge. Revealed knowledge happens when the mind is become no mind, in a deepest silence of the mind.
Okay.
the knowledge gets revealed. It is not filtered through the human mind.
Okay.
That is called revealed knowledge. That's a pure knowledge.
Okay.
So there's a realized knowledge is there. Oh, I understand. Yesterday you had a realization that I am not body. That's a realization.
Okay.
But there's some revelation takes place, which is in a deepest silence you real that revelation happens about the universe.
Okay.
We are speaking of that knowledge.
But that knowledge, when it comes through the mind, it gets filtered out, right? Because the mind cannot understand that.
It is coming through the mind, okay? But it gets expressed in a language called Sanskrit, okay?
Yeah.
Sanskrit has much more flexibility in expressing the revealed truths compared to other languages. It is a multi-layered, structured meaning will be there, emerge.
Okay.
Which points out to the truth itself cannot be expressed in the words. But it can be closest approximation or pointer can be given in language of Sanskrit. You understand the flexibility of Sanskrit? I'll tell you why Sanskrit is gives that flexibility in a separate talk. So what happens is it has to be ultimately for human communication, it has to be expressed through a language.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Otherwise you can't express it.
Yeah.
That expression brings in a sort of a limitation.
But Guruji, any infinite, no matter how many parts you make, you can't have a definite number of parts, right? So as soon as it is expressed through a mind or through a language, no matter how do you measure how close it is, because you can never
No, that's what I'm saying. So, you're right. First of all, here's the question. I'll try to translate the question. Yeste satya idre, satya. ಆ ಸತ್ಯ ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ಬಾಯಿ ಮುಂದೆ ಋಷಿಯ ಬಾಯಿಂದ ಬರಲಿ ಶುದ್ಧವಾದ ಆತ್ಮನ ಬಾಯಿಂದ ಬರಲಿ ಆ ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ಬಾಯಿ ಮುಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೆ ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ಬುದ್ಧಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಬುದ್ಧಿ ಬಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೆ ಅದು ಹೇಳೋ ಮಾತು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕರಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ಅಥವಾ ಹೇಳೋದು ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಆಯಿತಾ ಆದರೆ ಸತ್ಯ ನಾವು ಆ ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ಮೂಲಕ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಆದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೆ ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಓಕೆ ದರ್ ಸಮ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಸೊ ಟೂ ದರ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ದರ್ ಟೂ aspects. One is the tool, which is language. Okay, what is the best tool to express a truth? The Sanskrit has a best tool or flexibility to express the truth. First, I'll tell you why. So the Sanskrit has a multi-level meaning. Each can give more and more deeper, opens up more and more deeper. Right? But whatever you do, finally it stops at certain point. Where you can only point to the truth, but you cannot express the truth. For example, I'll say that is light. So I'll give you the characteristic of the light. Light is brightness, round and all. But still it's not expressing light. I can show you, point to the finger at the light. Okay? Right? Whatever I explain the light cannot be expressed. Then I show it. Then you look at that. Then you see, understand this light. So no matter whatever you do, all words can only point to certain level.
Okay.
So these are certain pointers which can point to the highest truth.
Okay. But how do you say something is better? When I compare to infinity, I can't say if 2 is closer to infinity or 3 is closer to infinity.
No. It's not 2 or 3 closer to infinity. See, these are given to you where you can directly experience the infinity by a pointer. This is the closest pointer.
How do you say it is the closest
one? That is the belief system which is not questioned in India. This they say for more than 15,000 years. They say these are directly pointing to the truth. That's the belief. And then there's another factor to that. Belief comes from two. Okay. So one is they believe that these sentences contain the truth, pointed to truth. They don't question. Second thing is they believe that once this truth comes from say Guru Mukha, the person who is realized, the truth, what is missing aspect of the whatever error is understanding, that gets corrected because it is coming as an experience. So they say just reading the truth is not sufficient. Just Guru uttering the truth is not sufficient. The Guru has to tell you the truth in such a way that you understand. Then experience come pointing out becomes the reality. In other words, it's saying there's a cookbook. You have to add salt. Half a spoonful of salt. Now which spoon? Spoon is this big, spoon is this big, spoon is this big. You don't know. Then your guru comes, cook guru comes, take this much, it will be over. So like that, the two aspects are required for realization, guru and vakya. Without that, realization is not complete. Now, guru also got it from his guru. There is somewhere it has been passed on. Okay? See, that's where the truth, people understood that they say, just words cannot give the point, words can show the truth, point to the direction to the, but error in understanding has to be corrected by a person who has the experience of that. So that's why they said, Shastra Vakya and Guru Mukha, both are required. So they say, for realization of truth, these are the necessary and sufficient conditions. Okay.
Not only that, the earlier knowledge came only as sound. Later only the printing and the word, nothing came, no? So it was always, they heard and they went to Guru Mukhena.
Guru Mukhena. No, that's actually, there are two parts to that. So he is questioning, that's a transmission mechanism. That's actually what you call education system. He is questioning how a words can show the truth. So words cannot, words can only point to the truth. For example, that's light is a point of the truth. Okay? Now he says any amount of words can point to the truth, you cannot point
the experience has to be his.
Here
show he has to experience the light.
No, he has to experience the light. So now he says words cannot sufficiently express it. Then I'm saying that's why we brought in two. One is guru is required and words are required. So now what guru helps is that whatever you point out as whatever you say, so you may say, I am saying this is the light. You may say that is the light. The guru says, no, come back here. So guru rules out, guru's job is to rule out what you are mistaking. Okay, guru's job is to point out correctly where it is. Okay, finally, remove, what I am saying is elimination and assertion has to get that.
But so, without words also they express.
Who?
Silent.
No, that's a different technology, sir, that I will tell you what is it. So now actually what you are getting into another teaching methodology. Okay. So the word, without words expressing silence, silence expressing something, I'll tell you what it is. Right? It's all actually told in Vedanta, it says, oh, silence and all. But then what is the meaning of that, I'll tell you later. Right? Because these are all Vedantic teaching itself. Now what we are getting, that's also actually a lot of corruption is there in teaching. The essence of what is silence in teaching, I'll tell you. Okay, so he is actually questioning me, how can word point out to reality? So I am saying word can point to the reality, they can be pointed, but they cannot describe the reality. But Sanskrit has the best ability to express the reality in the closest way.
In other words, the word becomes a Kshotriya, his experience becomes Brahmanishtha.
Words become...
It's a guru's qualification.
No. The Brahmanishta Guru not even know, may not know even Vakyas also. Okay, Brahmanishta Guru need not know Vakyas also, but he knows the essence of it. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa didn't even know any of these Vakyas. Okay, I'm not speaking in terms of Vakya. Okay, but he is questioning me, Vakya how can show? I'm telling you, Vakya can show because of two reasons. The language has a flexibility. Okay, Sanskrit has a language that's very much flexible compared to other language in showing the truth. Second, that can take you closest. Second is a guru is required to point out in error in your understanding. So, together these two, with your own effort, you need to see the truth or realize the truth. For example, yesterday I took three states. So now I didn't point out to you that I is the reality. I just showed you what is your unreal for you. Okay, so now finally you have to come to a conclusion, I didn't say that, you believe in me. Finally you have to come to a conclusion, the I is real. Like that, guru is able to eliminate what is not possible, what is wrong, then he is constantly trying to remove the obstacles in your thinking. With these two, you will be realized.
Okay, but I still have one doubt, how you can say something is better?
I'll come back. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಶಬ್ದಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಆ ಭಗವಂತನ ಕಾಣೋದು ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂತ. ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯಗಳು ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಒಪ್ಕೊಂಡೆ. ಆ ವಾಕ್ಯಗಳನ್ನ ಈಗ ಒಂದೇ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ, ನಾನು ಅದು ಲೈಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ, ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಲೈಟ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ, ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ, ಲೈಟಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳಕು ಬರ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಬೆಳಕು ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಲೈಟ್, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಲೈಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಹುಡುಗಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳಕು ಹುಡುಕಿ ಬೆಳಕು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಶಬ್ದಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಎಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಅವರು. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ರೈಟ್, ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಎನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಒಬ್ಬ ಕುರುಡ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ. ಆ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಕುರುಡನಿಗೆ ಬಿಳಿಯ ಬಣ್ಣ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ವೈಟ್ ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಹಿ ಡಸ್ಂಟ್ ನೋ ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್. ರೈಟ್, ಹೀ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಸಂಬಳಿ, ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಕಲರ್, ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್, ಬಿಳಿ ಬಣ್ಣ ಏನಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹುಡುಗ ಅವನಂದ್ರ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಫೆಲೋ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ವೈಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಹಿ ಟಚಸ್ ದಿ ಮೇಕ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸ್ ಟಚ್ ದಿ ವಾಲ್, ಗೋಡೆ ಮುಟ್ಲಿಗಳು ಬಿಳಿ ಬಣ್ಣ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಓ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ವೈಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್. ರೈಟ್, ಬಿಳಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಗಟ್ಟಿ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ನೌ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್, ನೋ ವೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್, ವೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಹಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್, ಹಿ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟಚ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್. ಆ ಬಿಳಿದಂದ್ರೆ ಹಾ ಅದು ಗೋಡೆ ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಒಂದು ಹಾಲಿದ್ದಾಗೆ ಮುಟ್ಟು. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಹಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ವೈಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಇದ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಷನ್. ನಮಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡುವಾಗ ಶಬ್ದಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಏನು ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. ನೋ ವೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ನಸ್ಲಿ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಡಕ್, ವೈಟ್ ಡಕ್, ಒಂದು ಬಾತುಕೋಳಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗೆ. ಹೌ ಇಸ್ ಬಾತುಕೋಳಿ, ಈ ಶೋಸ್ ಇದೆ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಕೈಯಿಂದ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಬಾತುಕೋಳಿ ಹೀಗಿದೆ. ಓ ನೋ ಐ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೈಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಬೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಹೌ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್, ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ದ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇಟ್. ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದಿರೋ ಮಾತ್ರ, ನಾವು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದ ವಿಷಯ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಕ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಆರ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್? ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದು ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಆರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ನೋ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ, ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ವಿಷಯ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡಿಂಟ್ ನೋ ಆತ್ಮ, ನೋ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಟು ಯು. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಆತ್ಮದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದಿದ್ರೆ ನೀ ಏನೇ ಶಬ್ದ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ. ನಾವು ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ನೋ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕನ್, ತಪ್ಪಾಗಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್ಲಿ, ದೆನ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ವೇದಾಂತ ಆರ್ ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಆರ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇದಾಂತ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇಂಟ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಟು ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಇಟ್, ನಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಮೋರ್ ನ್ಯೂ ನಾಲೆಜ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವೇ ದಿ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇನ್ಹೆರೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಯು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್, ನಾಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ನ್ಯೂ. ಓಕೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮೊಳಗೆ ಏನಿದೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ನಾ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದ ವಿಷಯ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ಮೊದಲು ಜಾಗೃತ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಸೂಚಿಸ್ಬಿದ್ದೆ, ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹೊಸ್ತಾಗಿ ನಂಬಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮ್ಗೇನು ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆತ್ಮದ ಅಜ್ಞಾನ ನಿವಾರಣೆ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಹಾಗೇ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಹೊಸ ವಿಷಯ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದು. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ರಾಂಗ್ಲಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇ. ನಾವು ಟು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎ ಗುರು ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಯು ಟು ಎಲಿಮಿನೇಟ್ ಆಲ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ನೋಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುರು ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಯು ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಓವರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇದಾಂತ. ಗುರುವಿನ ಮೂಲಕ ಆ ಶಬ್ದದ ಅರ್ಥ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ ಅಪಾರ್ಥಗಳು ಹೋಗ್ತವೆ, ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಗೋಸ್, ದೆನ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಶೈನ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆತ್ಮಂದ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೌ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್. ದಟ್ ಐ ಲವ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಸಾನ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಟ್ ವರ್ಸಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅದರ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್.
If no language is able to communicate that, that's what I said. How do you know if 2 is closer to infinity or 3 is closer to infinity?
No, that's what I'm trying to tell you. First is Sanskrit has a certain flexibility which other languages don't have.
Okay.
That we'll discuss as Sanskrit has some flexibility, we'll discuss separately.
Okay.
It's like a complete programming tool. C language is there, Fortran is there, COBOL is there, right?
Hmm.
Why C they use and why not COBOL?
It's easier to understand.
No, it has certain flexibility which COBOL doesn't have. There is a Fortran, there is a Lisp.
Yeah.
There are many languages.
Yeah.
Each specific purpose, there is a specific language. It's an expression tool. Sanskrit as an expression tool has much, many, many flexibility. You can ask the question sometime, not today, but keep the question, I'll explain to you. Okay? How to it has the ability to express the human consciousness in a much better way. Sanskrit shabda, bhashe, adalondo visheshate ide. ಆ ವಿಶೇಷತೆ ಮೂಲಕ ಆತ್ಮದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಭಾಷೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ. ಅದು ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಇವತ್ತು ಹೇಳಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾತ್ ಕೈ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್? ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಫೈನ್ ಇನ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ ಫೈನ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು, ವೈ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರಿ, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಷನ್? ವೈ ನಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟಿನ್? No, no. Why not use Latin as a language? Don't write formula. Use Latin to communicate.
We can if we have... Mathematics is just symbols, right?
No, what I'm saying is mathematics is a tool for communication. In a way, very precise way. Symbols.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So language is a set of symbols for communication.
Yeah.
Instead of mathematics, can you use Kannada?
We can if we just... change the
symbols. No, not symbols, sir. I'm saying mathematics as a structure, right? Formula, integration, differentiation. There
are
set of
all those are just symbols, right?
Operations.
Yeah, but mathematics itself is abstract. If I say what is one, I can't answer what one is. Because in order to say one, I need to always compare it. I have to say one chair or one table. But
right.
I cannot answer what one is.
So, you use a language, use a communication mechanism to communicate some abstract truth,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Which you think is closest and which can be understood by most of the people.
Okay.
Sanskrit is one such thing. Is it the best? It is the best known to humankind right now.
Okay.
There is there something better than that? Nobody knows. That's why it's called Deva Bhasha. Deva Bhasha is called Sanskrit. ಓಕೆ. ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತ ಶಬ್ದದ ಮೂಲಕ ಆ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಕೊಡಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಾವು ಭಾಳ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ವಿಷಯ ಕಲಿಕಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ ಬಳಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಸಾಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊದಲನೆಯದು ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ. ಓಕೆ, ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯ. There is jnanam and pradnanam. Jnanam means knowledge. Pradnanam means superior knowledge. Okay? So jnanam is knowledge. Pradnanam means beyond knowledge. Right?
Superior knowledge is different. Beyond knowledge.
I use the wrong word. Beyond knowledge. Jnanam means knowledge. Pradnanam means beyond knowledge. Which is consciousness. Consciousness is beyond knowledge. Consciousness, when applied to the objective world, becomes knowledge. But consciousness itself is beyond knowledge. Okay? Do you understand? Chaitanyam or consciousness is called Brahman. So this is the first definition of Brahman. Okay? And the ultimate definition of Brahman. So what he is saying is, the consciousness is the ultimate reality. Consciousness is the supreme reality. Chaitanyam is the supreme reality. And the Chaitanya, Brahma anthe helidre, Bhagavanta anthe helidre, Chaitanya. Okay? The consciousness is the ultimate reality of existence. Astitva, existence. So conscious, what is consciousness then? Is the knowing ability is called consciousness. You have to understand what is meaning consciousness. Consciousness is a word. Ability to know is called consciousness. What is non-conscious has no ability to know. ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ತಿಳಿದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು. ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್, ಅದು ಲೋವರ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್. ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್
ತ್ರೀ ರೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್.
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರೋಲ್, ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಒಂದೇ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್, ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ. ಅದು ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಮನ ಅಂತ ಆಗಲಿ, ಅದು ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅದು ಅದು ಮಹಾವಾಕ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ, ಅದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಅದು ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಟೇಲಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು ಚೈತನ್ಯವೇ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ಚೈತನ್ಯವೇ ಭಗವಂತ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ವಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆನಿ ವೇಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾಡ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಹೌ ಗಾಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್ ಆರ್ ಗಾಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸುಪ್ರೀಂ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ, ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನಂ. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಪ್ರೀತ, ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್? Is this conscious? No. So are you conscious? Yes. Why you call yourself as conscious?
I know that is.
So the knowing ability is called consciousness. Okay? What is known is knowledge. Tilidukolluva shakti chaitanyake. The fundamental reality of the universe is the knowing ability. It's called pradhana. And the fundamental reality of universe is called existence, astitva. Existence is the fundamental reality.
Fundamental ability is consciousness.
No, it's not ability. Reality itself.
No, fundamental reality is existence.
Existence is conscious. Okay. Existence is conscious. It is not the ability, it is the fundamental ability of existence is consciousness. It's not a function. It's not an action. Okay. Existence is conscious.
You're conscious of existence.
No. You are not conscious of existence. Existence is consciousness. Existence itself is consciousness.
So that means the stone exists, it's conscious.
That is the object. So next is what appears is appearance in consciousness. We'll go understand. Existence itself is consciousness. Existence is not different from consciousness. Okay, I don't say existence has consciousness. If its existence has consciousness, if consciousness is removed, existence is still there.
That's what I said. Stone has
to exist,
but no consciousness.
Don't go to the stone now. Go to the primary reality. Then we'll go to the stone. Okay. Everything exists. Stone exists. I exist. You exist. That existence, what the word existence is consciousness. The stone may not be expressing consciousness. That's a different thing. At the existence level, it's conscious. The entire universe is existence, which is consciousness, which is actually totally opposite view of science. So you call it as matter, right? So we say matter has no reality. Matter is appearance in consciousness. Okay. First, consciousness is the chaitanya. Chaitanya, madam, tilkolo shakti idiya? ಇದಕ್ಕಿದೆಯಾ? ಆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಶಕ್ತಿಗೆ ಭಗವಂತಂದೇಳು, ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಶಕ್ತಿಗೆ, ರೈಟ್? ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ವಿಷಯ ವಸ್ತು ಜ್ಞಾನ. ಆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಶಕ್ತಿ ನನ್ನಲ್ಲಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ನನಗೆ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ನನಗೆ ದೇಹಕ್ಕೆ, ದೇಹದ ಮೂಲಕ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಶಕ್ತಿ. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ದಿ ಅಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ನೋ, ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಪವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ. ದೇಹದ ಮೂಲಕ ಆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ವ್ಯಕ್ತ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸ್ಟೋನ್, ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಸ್. ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸಸ್ ಟು ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರತಿಭಾ. Okay, existence is consciousness, everything manifest is expression of consciousness. So it as good as saying a musician has the ability of music, So he sings a song, it's an expression. Existence and its expression.
Guruji, then how do I know that that bottle exists?
Do you know it exists?
My vision and my body says
it
exists.
Right.
But how do I know? I can know only my existence, right?
So this doesn't exist in your existence point of view. Because it's a part of existence.
Okay.
In Pradnanam, there's no other. Everything is only existence is there. At Pradnanam level.
Okay.
At the consciousness level, okay, its example is water, ocean and wave. Neeru, samudra, matu ale. Okay. What is wave water? Water?
Water.
Ocean is water?
Yeah.
Water, ocean and wave, these are three appearances. Fundamental reality is water. Okay? Neeru, adra basic. Neeru adu existence. Essence. Neeru samudra kanutade, neeru ale kanutade. The water appears as ocean and water appears as wave. Has any change happened in the water?
No.
Right? That way, existence appears as stone, existence appears as you. There's no change in the existence as such.
Okay, but how do I know that existence is there in that?
Are you speaking of a non-existent thing? See, existence, that's what I'm trying. There is an intuitive knowledge that existence is there. Intuitive.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So you exist is intuitive knowledge.
Yeah.
The bottle exists also is intuitive knowledge for you. Non-existence is cannot come in our mind.
Okay.
Right?
But for me, I exist is intuitive, but bottle exists is not so intuitive.
No, bottle exists also is intuitive. Otherwise, you will not go and touch the bottle if you get a question mark. So you see the form and the form of the bottle. Right? Then you grab it. The existence aspect of the bottle has already come into your mind as intuitively.
Okay.
Okay, now we are going into types of knowledge. Little bit we are, there are different types of knowledge, okay? So there's a direct experience, para pratyaksha, inference anumana, okay? Intuitive and aparoksha, indirect. So now this theory of knowledge I will take it to you. Right? Right now, you put a question mark on that theory of knowledge. So I'll tell you what is knowledge and how it can be experienced. I'll take it separate because it is too much of deviation from this. So right now you take it that existence is reality.
Okay.
The fundamental nature of universe is existence. And existence is consciousness. Okay? Chaitanya? Adu Atma. ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಅದೇ ಭಗವಂತ. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಡು ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅವೇರ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಶಿಯಸ್? ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ಟು ಯು.
ಸೊ ನೌ ಡಸ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಟಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಡಸ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಟಲ್ ನೌ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್?
ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಪೋರಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಹೆಡ್. I have a separate topic about types of knowledge. We'll take up that. Right? So you are questioning existence, understanding existence is called intuitive knowledge. Okay, what is intuitive knowledge and about that I'll tell you separately. Right now, this itself is a big topic. That's why I want to get into details of this. ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೆವಿ ಆಗ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಹಾಂ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕೆ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆ ತಿಂತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಾ? ಹಾಂ, ನಾವು ಬಂದದ್ದೇನೋ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ ಇದೇನೋ ಹೋಯ್ತಾ ಯಾವ ಕಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ? ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಏನು ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬೇಕಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಆತ್ಮ ಅಥವಾ ಭಗವಂತ ನಾವು ಏನೇನೋ ರೂಪ ಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ. ನಿಜವಾದ ಆತ್ಮ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಸ್ತಿತ್ವ. ಓಕೆ, ನಿಜವಾದ ಆತ್ಮ ಅಂದರೆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾನು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ನೀವು ಇದ್ದೀರೇನಪ್ಪ? So, do you exist?
Yeah.
Are you conscious?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right? So, this is God. But the consciousness is not coming from your body. You are confusing that consciousness, body is conscious. It is not. You are thinking the mind is conscious, it is not. But you know what is consciousness, right? And that existence and consciousness is God. It is not dependent on the body, your body depends on that.
People are not born or dead.
That will come to that. Okay. Right? The birth and death will come to that. First is, do you exist?
Sure.
Are you conscious?
Absolutely.
So now, your answer is personal answer. Right? For me. But existence of consciousness is impersonal. It's for everybody. And from that your body and mind is working.
BMI is in consciousness.
BMI is appearance in consciousness. Okay. So BMI is appearance in consciousness, just like wave is appearance in ocean. Body, mind, intellect is a appearance in consciousness.
Guruji, you said that bottle doesn't exist from my existence point.
My existence is individual here. Hmm. I'm speaking from existence point of view, everything is existence. There's no separation between bottle and an elephant. From water point of view, all waves are water.
So even bottle also consciousness?
Existence.
Yeah, you said existence is consciousness.
Hmm.
So bottle is also consciousness.
No. Look at from existence point of view, everything is existence. There's no concept of consciousness or anything. Existence is consciousness. From it doesn't existence point of view, water doesn't know there's a wave. Everything is water. Right? So at Pragnanam level, everything is consciousness and everything is existence. Is that clear, much clear? Any doubts? It's not individual I'm speaking of. It is the universal. But as an individual, you know it. You know that I am existing and I am conscious. Okay? Naan iddene mattu naan. That is called existence is called Sat. I am conscious is called Chit. Okay? But Vedanta is not giving you something new information. Vasa information kodtaal nimge. What you know, but what you are confusing, we are clarifying. Okay?
Clarity.
Nimma confusion, you know, I exist, I am conscious because I am the body. Vedanta is saying, you exist in your consciousness in spite of the body, irrespective of the body. Vyathasa kotha kotha? You exist in your consciousness irrespective of the body. Body is only just appearance, like wave is just appearance in water. So I am not telling you anything new. I am only bringing little bit of correction in your understanding that existence consciousness, my property you are saying. I'm saying it's not your property, it's a property, fundamental reality which is manifesting in you. That's all is understand teaching in Vedanta, nothing more. But that teaching has leads to a lot of peace. Artha kya? Astitva and Brahma to Bhagavanta Chaitanya. Brahma and Chaitanya Surupi.